Hey guys, welcome to my channel. Hope you're having a great day. Today's book is going to be Nightguard and the Rise of a Hero. At the throne room of King Henry, two men are talking.
This witch must be stopped, said King Henry.
Your Majesty, we do not have the resources to do that. The witch has already destroyed 3/4 of your army, and the remaining men come here to seek refuge and have claimed that she was on her way here, said Peter.
Then we defend Camelot and a people until our dying breath, said King Henry.
As you wish, my king. I will prepare our remaining men to fight for Camelot, said Peter.
Perhaps I can be of assistance, said a man.
State yourself and your business, ordered Peter as he took his sword out.
I am the magic master. I have come here to help you, said the magic master.
Can you combat this witch? Asked King Henry.
No. But I have a proposition that will save everyone, answered the magic master.
You dare waste my time, shouted King Henry.
Your Majesty, I am one of the three ultimates, and there are forces at work here you will not understand, said the magic master calmly.
How dare you address the king like that, said Peter.
I merely state what is true, said the magic master, turning to look straight at Peter, and I tell you this right now.
Camelot will fight until the bitter end, continued the magic master.
And what is this bitter end? Asked Peter.
Camelot will die, said the magic master.
Get this cur out of my sight, said King Henry as he got out of his seat.
And prepare my chariots. We are going to fight this witch and win, said King Henry.
As you wish, my king, said Peter.
Move, old man, lest I move you myself, continued Peter.
I have one more comment, my king, said the magic master, turning his attention to King Henry.
Someone with more honor in their heart shall wield that sword you carry, continued the magic master.
Get him out of my sight, snapped King Henry.
You heard the king. Move it, said Peter.
As you wish, said the magic master, as he walked out of the king's throne room.
Chapter 2. A few days later, King Henry and his men were preparing to defend Camelot, when suddenly a loud thud was heard at the doors of the castle.
I will offer you a chance of surrender, said a mean-looking woman in a dress.
You will die, witch, roared King Henry, as he lifted his sword and started to attack the mean-looking woman.
You call me witch one more time, Henry, and not by my proper name. I will beat you for eternity, said the mean-looking woman.
You will not beat my king, said Peter, as he ambushed the mean-looking woman.
Bolcane Lucio, chanted the mean-looking woman over and over.
A strange smoke came around Peter. What's happening to me? Screamed Peter as his body turned to dust.
You will die, witch, said King Henry as he attacked the mean-looking woman.
Not by the likes of you, I'm afraid, said the mean-looking woman as she started chanting again.
Susan, stop what you are doing, said the magic master, who appeared out of nowhere.
Finally, someone who addresses me by my proper name, said Susan as she performed a spell on King Henry, binding him like a mummy.
I taught this magic to you that you may help people, not for you to hurt them, said the magic master.
Sorry, swine, but I find it easier doing what I want than helping others, laughed Susan, as she lifted her hands and started shooting lightning at the magic master.
There'll be another to stop you and your madness, said the magic master, as he deflected Susan's lightning.
Volcum de Malario, continued the magic master.
What was that supposed to do, old man? Mocked Susan.
I just banished you for 1,000 years, said the magic master, as a giant suction portal opened and then sucked Susan in.
I'll be back, and mark my words, I will have my revenge, screamed Susan, as she got sucked into the suction portal.
I'm sure you will be, said the magic master, as he grabbed King Henry's sword.
Chapter 3. 1,000 years later, in a little town called Carthage, a man is on a farm feeding his cows.
There you go, Betsy. Keep eating that nice, delicious corn, said Galen, as he gave more corn to his cow, Betsy.
Dad, are you talking to Betsy again? Asked Andy as he walked into the barn.
No, son, I'm feeding the cows, said Galen.
as he quickly stopped talking to Betsy. "Well, anyway, Mom sent me in here to tell you that your truck died," said Andy. "Dang it, I thought I fixed it," said Galen, scratching his beard. "It must be the radiator again," continued Galen. "I'll finish feeding the cows if you want to go fix your truck," offered Andy. "Thanks, Andy," said Galen, walking out. "Anytime, Dad," said Andy. "Oh, and I know why your truck keeps breaking down," said Andy. "Why?" asked Galen. "It's a Ford and not a Chevy," laughed Andy. "Son, you got to watch what you're saying," laughed Galen as he left the barn to go to his workshop where his truck was. "Alright, so what's the problem with you, truck?" said Galen as he lifted the hood to his truck. "Just what I observed. The radiator is fried," said Galen. "I need your help," said the Magic Master as he walked into Galen's workshop. "Who are you?" said Galen as he grabbed a crowbar off his desk.
"One who bears a gift," said the Magic Master.
"What kind of gift?" said Galen, tightening his grip on his crowbar. "You are one of the last descendants of King Henry. I have watched you help people and talk to your cows. You have the heart of a servant, which is why I chose to give this sword to you, that you may vanquish this evil foe," said the Magic Master.
"Look, man, first off, I don't talk to my cows. And second off, you need to go to the pros about this, like the Freedom Fighters or Dr. Maniac," said Galen.
"They are busy with other threats, Galen, and the only way your foe can be vanquished is with this sword, with you wielding it," said the Magic Master, putting the sword in Galen's hand and disappearing. Chapter 4. "Galen, get up. Are you okay?" asked Donna, as she gave Galen a cup of water.
"What?" asked Galen.
"Andy found you unconscious in your workshop," said Donna.
"It's nothing. I better get back to work," said Galen as he got up.
"Are you sure? We should probably get you to a doctor," said Donna.
Honest, I'm fine," said Galen, rubbing his head.
As Galen and Donna were talking, they heard Andy shout for help.
"Where's the sword?" said a stranger outside.
"Great, it wasn't a dream," grumbled Galen.
"What's not a dream?" asked Donna.
"I'll explain later," said Galen, getting up then running away from Donna to look for Andy.
Chapter 5.
"I will not ask again. Tell me where the sword is or your son dies," snarled the stranger again.
"You're on my property. Get off and I won't call the police," said Galen.
"Fool, you think you can beat me?"
"I am Susan," said Susan.
"Dede Lokim," she continued, as a giant energy cage surrounded Galen.
"Where's my son?" demanded Galen, clenching his fists.
"You're not in a place to demand anything," snapped Susan.
"Call your sword," said the Magic Master inside Galen's head.
"What? How are you inside my head?" thought Galen.
"Look, I will explain everything to you later. Just do as I say. You can summon your sword when your mind is calm. Just take a deep breath and clear your mind," said the Magic Master.
"You think you're going to help him, Magic Master? My magic has tripled since you banished me all those years ago," roared Susan, as she mumbled Ores over and over.
"Remember what I told you," said the Magic Master as his voice faded away.
"Guess I got no choice," said Galen as he took a deep breath.
"Ha! The Magic Master couldn't help you," mocked Susan.
As Susan kept mocking Galen, they both heard a loud whoosh from his workshop.
"The sword," said Galen.
"That sword will be mine," said Susan.
"Not on my watch," said Galen as he caught the sword, breaking the energy cage.
"What's happening to me?" said Galen as his body started teleporting away.
"Bye, Galen. We'll meet again soon. But in the meantime, I think I'll visit with your family," cackled Susan.
"No!" screamed Galen. Chapter 6.
As Galen was looking around, he noticed the Magic Master was looking for him.
"Are you okay, Galen?" asked the Magic Master.
"You took me away from my family," said Galen angrily.
"Galen, you must understand. Even with that sword, you would not have been able to defend your family. You do not know how to use it," said the Magic Master.
"Where are we?" asked Galen.
"We are what you would call Albany, New York," answered the Magic Master.
I have to save my family, said Galen. In order to save your family, you must save the world and stop Susan, said the Magic Master.
Fine, but I'm not a hero, said Galen.
Fair enough. Lesson number one. Always have your blade ready, said the Magic Master.
What? Said Galen.
Sword of Marrow, chanted the Magic Master, as a sword materialized in his hand and he started to swing at Galen.
Hey, watch it, said Galen as he barely dodged the attack.
Susan will not hesitate to kill you.
Therefore you cannot hesitate, said the Magic Master.
Now get into a fighting position, he continued.
All right, said Galen as he pointed his sword at the Magic Master.
You get the first move, said the Magic Master.
Got it, said Galen as he started to swing his sword at the Magic Master wildly.
You will not win without discipline, said the Magic Master, blocking Galen's strike and disarming him of his sword.
You still have a lot to learn, said the Magic Master.
This is pointless. Just call some of the superheroes, said Galen.
Galen, I know you are frustrated, but you must keep a clear head, lest you have the same fate as your great-grandfather, said the Magic Master.
Are you threatening me? Asked Galen.
No, I am stating what is true, and I tell you this. You will rescue your family, but you must not do it on your time.
You have to trust me, said the Magic Master.
I don't have to do anything, said Galen, walking out.
Chapter 7. Meanwhile, back in Carthage, at the house of Galen and Donna,
you'll never get away with this, Galen. We'll come back, said Donna.
Oh, I'm counting on it, said Susan.
Speaking of which, I hope you continue on having fun talking to the wall, cackled Susan as she walked out.
She's annoying, muttered Susan.
Now where was I?
Ah, yes. Fire, air, water, earth, forme a linguistos, she continued.
Why do you summon me? Asked the elements as they formed together to make a man.
Be a deer and find me the Magic Master and his apprentice, said Susan.
As you wish, said the elements.
Chapter 8.
How do I save my family? Do I play the Magic Master's game? Or do I go back to my farm to rescue them, thought Galen.
How about you die, said the elements as he flew at Galen.
Who are you? Asked Galen.
I am the elements, servant to Susan, said the elements as he started to attack Galen.
Great, said Galen as he held his hand out.
You think you could summon your sword, fool? Think again, said the elements.
What, why isn't my sword coming to me? Said Galen.
Your mind isn't clear, said the elements, punching Galen in the face.
I don't need my sword to take you out, said Galen, as he fell to the ground.
Without your sword, you have no power, said the elements, shooting Galen with a water blast.
Galen, come with me peacefully, or I will destroy you, said the elements calmly.
What, so Susan can turn me into a little frog? Said Galen, giving the elements an uppercut to the face.
Your futiles are admirable, but they will not save you, said the elements, shrugging off Galen's uppercuts.
Be gone, elements, said the Magic Master.
How'd you get here, Galen?
Rather, Magic Master, asked Galen.
I followed you, said the Magic Master.
You will never keep me from my master's goal, Magic Master, said the elements, surrounding the Magic Master and Galen with a circle of fire.
Here's your sword, said the Magic Master.
Thanks, said Galen.
Fire evaporo, chanted the Magic Master, as the fire turned into smoke.
My master will destroy you, Night Guard, sneered the elements as he retreated.
Who's the Night Guard? Asked Galen.
You are, which is why I must teach you how to properly wield that sword, before Susan sends any more of her cronies, said the Magic Master.
Then teach me, said Galen.
Let us begin, said the Magic Master, as the master and apprentice walked into the sunset.
Well, as usual, subscribe, leave a comment, like this video, share it with your friends, turn on your notifications, And if you want to see current Vortex news, then check out our Facebook page or our awesome Instagram page, which is new, by the way. And if you want to see books and stuff, then check out our awesome website. Links down below, and see ya!